What's going on, guys? Has been a minute. Been like 4 or 5 days, I would say. But this is the updated squad. I think I showed you this lineup overview. It's the same video clip, to be really honest with you. This is what the team looks like as of right now. See me going over the stats for the new Julio Jones that we just picked up. He's not a new card. He came out during the playoffs, but he's still a good card. You know, 94 speed is what you want at wide receiver right now. So this is like an overview of the defense, and we did also end up picking up kicker Bo Jackson because we need to move on from Dan Bailey. Okay, with Dan Bailey, I couldn't hit field goals or extra. I couldn't hit field goals from over 50 yards, I would say, and Bo Jackson can hit. I think 60 yards is his breaking point. I hadn't tried to kick one with him from 60 yards yet, but we're going to see how they play in this game. Just to go a little overview of what I have, we are 92 overall, and we're going to be hopping into this game. And the reason, y'all read the title of the video now, this guy played like a straight up, like any bum would in Madden 18. Like, this is one of them games. He was a halfback pitch bum, is what he was. And I'm not knocking him because it worked, but like, I just don't see how people can have fun running the same exact play over and over and over. The same motion over and over and over. I get that the play is really unstoppable, but you see how I'm playing, right? I'm coming out slinging it. You know, first 3 or 4 plays of the game, you know, I passed all on this drive except for one play where I handed it to Bo Jackson on the draw. But, like, you see I'm consistently completing passes because I know how to get down the field and pass the ball. Well, that's not the case with my opponent. I mean, he would rather rely on his run game. But at the end of the day, it is up to him. It is up to him what he wants to run. Like, you can't force nobody to run anything.
But, got him!
You know, that was not 91 zone. That was his user skills right there. So, you know, you gotta give him credit where credit's due. But this is the play I'm talking about—the motion halfback pitch—and we shut it down on the first play because he stuck me in cover 2 man. I just happened to get out there in my user. I didn't get my preset audibles down on defense yet. But like, you see what 91 zone does for you on the field. Like, it helps better more if you click on. But y'all, look at this play. I had to dig down deep in my playbook to find this play now. You know, that's the first time I ever ran that play. I subbed in Tyreek Hill for that specific purpose. He doesn't have elite tier spin moves or juke moves, but that boy quick.
Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no, to the no, no, no.
Yeah, that's what the pitch play does. Like, yeah, the pitch play has really good potential for home run hitters. That's why he runs it. That's why everybody runs halfback pitch. I don't run halfback pitch, except when people want to be a bum and run halfback pitch all game like this guy, and then I go to my halfback pitch. But you know, I basically like a punt right there. I knew I probably wasn't gonna complete that pass, so might as well try my luck. But he tried his luck and tested my user, and you know, we're eating right now.
Yeah,
we had, you know, Bo Jackson's got the moves now. That's why I love Bo Jackson. That's why I still think he's the best running back in the game, because he can spin, juke, and truck. He can do it all. So, I thought I could, you know, spin it to the end zone right there.
Expose him!
But we exposed right there, man. I'm not scared to run a fake field goal, flip pass. But you see, this is how effective the halfback pitch is. And I'm not going to lie, I was really salty during this game. Like, this game really had me heated. I mean, and then he catches. I mean, I guess it was a wide open pass, but I don't know. Like, there's nothing that aggravates me more than people that low pass every single play. Like, if they pass the ball, they low pass, which is the safest pass to go. The safest pass to do. But he comes out trying to run the pitch again. We shut it down. And I don't know how my players didn't react on this play. Like, my user was there, but Earl Thomas, he could have jumped underneath that and picked it. Possibly could have pick-sixed it, but, you know, that would have been asking for too much. But, you know, he gets through on the pitch again. And, again, man, if you don't have unfakeable and secure tackler on for ability chems on all your defensive players, you're doing it wrong. But we see, we get the pick six right there. That's the second time he's tested my user. And I was just sitting right there underneath that route the whole time. And, you know, Shazier's 90-plus jumping or whatever he has allowed me to lunge in front of that and get an animation. But you see, he goes to the halfback pitch constantly on fourth down. And I know what you might be thinking, like, Andrew, why are you complaining about it? Why don't you just stop it? Well, that's the problem. Like, you can't really – there's no way to effectively shut down the pitch every single time they run it. The best thing you could do is sit in cover four and bring your safeties down, spread your linebackers, and crash your D-line to the outside. And it sounds like a lot, but it really doesn't take that long. It's what I consider base adjustments. But that's the best way to contain it for at least 3 or 4 yards. You know what I'm saying? He's still going to pop one every once in a while because my safeties, they just whiff. They just completely whiff and miss. And you see they do that pretty often in this game right here. Right here, I tried to playmaker. I thought I could fit that pass in, but we end up throwing it into triple, quadruple coverage, as people will call it, and we throw it to the man himself, Richard Sherman. So he comes out here. We got our pinch two dog press blitz. And this is something new that I learned. But here, let me get them ankles right quick. But anyway, as I was saying, if you're in 3-4 odd, you can, as long as you make the same adjustment to your D-line and linebackers, it doesn't matter if you show blitz or not. It can even be out of any 3-4 odd cover two. Like, as long as it's out of 3-4 odd, you can call any Tampa 2, and all you got to do is pinch your D-line, crash them out, and yeah, that's an L. That play had me really heated at the very end. I was trying to fully explain that blitz to you, but I forgot that was the last play of the game. But yeah, that's how we take our L. And like, it just makes no logical sense to run the ball with 20 seconds left on 4th and 5 or whatever it was. But anyway, credit to my opponent. He got the win. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.